So hello everyone, so this is the first video tutorial on Python where I will go through the basic to advanced level. So this is the first topic of the Python programming. So please subscribe to my channel if you haven't subscribed my channel for daily videos. So now we will see what is identifier and reserved words in a Python. So here the first question arises, what is identifier? So let me give you the definition, then we will explain that definition in my own words. Yeah, so here is the answer. Name in a Python known as identifier. It can be class name, function name, variable name. So what that mean? So let me explain this definition. Suppose my name is Rajat Upadhyay, that means my identification is Rajat Upadhyay. If you are talking about Rajat Upadhyay, that means you are talking about me. To identify anything, we give some name to that particular thing. Suppose you live in a particular city and in a particular area. So how you will tell anyone else that I live here? You can't tell that I live in only Kanpur. You have to specify the particular location where you live. So that is why every particular place have a particular name to identify that location. Like that, in a Python we give the name to the class, to the variable, to the function, to identify that class, that function, that variable. I hope you understand what is identifier now. So there is some rules and regulation to define the identifier, like my name. So there is some rule. There is my first name is Rajat and the last name is Upadhyay. I can't use like Upadhyay Rajat. I can't use first last name and at the end the first name. So there is some rule. I can't use the digit number in my real name, that RAJA. Suppose I will use 7, so that is the not right way. Like this, if you are defining any identifier in a Python, so there are some rules. Basically there are 5 rules which we will see with the help of example. Yeah, so here is the first rule, allowed characters. So what all the characters are allowed to defining the identifier? So there is allowed character is all alphabet, that is A to Z, all the digit, that is 0 to 9, and in symbol only underscore is allowed. So let me give you the example. So here I am using Python console. So suppose I am taking like A equal to 1, 2, and I am printing that. So you can see that is 2. So here I have defined one variable which is A, that is alphabet, so that is printing as 2. So I can use any word like mastermind and 2. If you will print this, yeah, and suppose we will use the digits. So suppose I'm taking A1 equal to 2, 3, then we will print A1. Yeah, that's it. So now the next step is underscore. Suppose I'm using as mastermind coder equal to 2, and if you will print this, yeah, it will not show the error, that is allowed underscore. Suppose if you are using dollar mastermind, then it will show the error, because except underscore nothing symbol is allowed in a Python. Yeah, so our first rule is explained. Now we'll go for the second rule. Python is a case sensitive language. What does that mean? Let me give you the example. So suppose I am defining one variable like test equal to 1 and printing test, then it will give the error that test is not defined, because this test and this test is different. So here all this means a equal to 1 and a equal to 1, these two variables are different. So this is because of case sensitive language. So Python is a case sensitive language that you should know. Now we will go for the third rule. Should not start with a digit. So let me give you the example. If we are taking one variable like 1 tech and giving like 1, so it will not support this variable identifier. Yeah, it is showing the syntax error. So in identifier we can't define any identifier with the starting of the digit. You can use that digit in between or at the end, but you can't use at the starting. Now the rule number 4, which is we can't use reserved words as an identifier. So what is reserved word, we will see in this video only. So we will talk about later. Now we'll see the fifth rule, which is use of underscore. So that means if we are using underscore at the starting of the any variable, any function, then that's mean that variable, that function and that class is private. Yeah, so now our all the five rules is explained. Now let me revise all the things. Here allowed character is all alphabets, all the digit and underscore symbol. I have also showed you the example. And the second rule is Python is case sensitive language. There are different meaning of different letter, and it should not be start with digit. And the fourth one, Python does not support the reserved word as a identifier. To make any identifier as a private, we use underscore. So now we will see what is reserved word. Let me give you the definition first. A word which have a particular meaning known as a reserved word. What does it mean? That means, suppose if you are talking about the cat, so that is a particular meaning that cat is a animal. Like suppose you are talking about the forest, so that means you are talking about that there is a group of trees, rivers, so that is a forest. So every that words have a particular meaning. Like this in a Python, there are some reserved word which have a particular meaning, which we use for a particular condition statement, in an error handling, in a data type. So there are basically 33 reserved word in a Python. So as we know that we can't use reserved word as an identifier. So first I will show what are the reserved word in a Python. So here is the list 33. These 33 keywords in a Python, these are the reserved word in a Python. So let me give you one scenario where I have seen you can't use reserved word as a identifier. Suppose I am using as a break. So I am giving one example here. I am defining like break equal to 1. Yeah, you can see it is showing the error. I hope you understand each of the line of this tutorial. If you have any query, kindly let me know in the comment section. I have also shared the link in the description box for the notes of this video. Thank you so much guys for watching this video. Please stay with us for more tutorial on Python from basic to advanced. Thank you so much guys for watching.